हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। आई होप कि आपने मेरा चैनल सब्सक्राइब कर दिया होगा, और अगर आपने नहीं किया है सो प्लीज़ सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल, डू लाइक इट एंड शेयर इट विद योर फ्रेंड्स। आई होप यू विल डेफिनेटली गोना लाइक इट। और आपको कोई भी कंप्लेन हो या कोई भी इशू हो, प्लीज़ राइट इट इन द कमेंट सेक्शन गिवन बिलो। ओके, सो आज हम लोग अपनी पोएम डार्कलिंग थ्रश का जो बाकी का पोर्शन था उसे कवर करेंगे, मेन थीम एंड क्रिटिकल remarks, which is very much important for the long answers. So without wasting any time, let's start. Okay, there are two themes of the poem, nature and the search of meaning. I know nature it will be there, kyunki hum log ne pure poem ke explanation mein dekha tha ki how Thomas Hardy the poet has used different words in the poem for describing the human lost in faith by the comparing it with the nature phenomena like barren landscape, beginning of a day, sunset, so that all of the emotions of a human being, the depression of the human being is shown by the nature. Like the barren landscape means no hope, our mind is converted into a barren land, deserted mind, kyunki wahan pe koi bhi ab hope nahi bacha hai, what will I gonna do, because totally they are the human are getting replaced by the machines due to industrial revolution, and how that copper skate is indicating the wall between the 19th century and the 20th century. So that is why nature is going to be, and the search of meaning is there, because in the whole poem we can see easily that how he is searching for the life, because he don't knowing what to do. The 19th century is at the end, and he is not knowing what he gonna do, because all of the scenario in the society is getting changed. I mean, your policy, your behavior, your relations, everything is gonna change. Political changes are there, economical changes. So he is not knowing what to do. So he is search of the meaning, in search of the meaning of his life. So what I will do now? I don't have any meaning, I don't have any hope in my life, I don't know what I'm going to do, because my work is now will be done by the machine. So I'm totally hopeless. So that is why the another theme of the poem is search of meaning. Okay, so I am the video, you can see the notes provided by me from which I'm going to teach you. So listen it carefully. Let's start. Nature, the theme, first theme, nature. In the Thomas Hardy's poem, nature is governed by the cycle of life and death and is largely indifferent to human needs or desires. The Darkling Thrush is about the death of the hope in the 19th century for having lost in faith in no other beloved forces. Hardy has depicted this through a barren landscape on a depressing wintry evening. As I told you, he has compared that bare landscape, the winter evening, with the human feeling, what he's currently feeling at that time. Means he did not know what to do. So that emotions, that feeling of a human is depicted by that depressing winter evening. He is depressive because he's not having any work now. So that depression of a human is shown by the winter evening, and that no hope, no desire is shown by the barren landscape. Means no water, nothing is there for him to do now. So it is barren, totally barren landscape. The first of the metaphor used by the Hardy to suggest death is the adjective employed to describe the frost spectre gray. As I've told you, spectre gray is here as a gray, as a ghost. Means his life is totally lifeless, ghost. Means there is nothing, greenery is life. Means no happiness is there in his life. There are totally darkness around him. He's not finding any way. It's just totally dark. And for giving it a metaphor meaning, the spectre gray word is used by the poet to tell his gray as a ghost. Okay? The weakening eye of day. The sun sinking towards the horizon has none of the sun's usual connotation of brightness and warmth. Means जो usually brightness or warmth होती है sun की, it is not there. Why? Because it is sunset. Means sun is sinking down. Sun is sinking down means the hope, the desire of living of a human is setting down. As that is compared here with the sunset. Why? Because there is no hope. What to do? Simple as a jobless. Of course, if the person is not having the mode of earning, what he will do? How he's gonna manage? How he will feed his family? How he gonna feed himself? So they are totally that depression, that emotion is depicting by the nature, and that sunset mean that is showing that how his feeling is, his life is totally covered with the darkness, and his hope is totally vanished. Means he don't know what to do now. He's totally in dark, clueless. Instead of the leftovers of winter, the dregs make even the sun appear desolate, with which approach of night and darkness further the idea of death and lifeless wine, which remind him of the broken string of the musical instrument which cannot produce any sound or music, this underlying the absence of harmony and therefore of joy, the speaker vision of life. Matlab, there is no joy. The instrument music is compared with the joy of the person, means no harmony in life. When you are happy, when there is life of harmony, when it is going smoothly, soothing. But now it is not there because his door, he is jobless, clueless, he is not knowing. So his life is totally in depressing way, depressing tone. There is no harmony in his life, no peace in life. We feel happy, we feel peace when we are having something, when we see our family happy, when we complete their needs. But he is not having the money to complete their need as well as his own need. He don't know how he is going to feed his family. There are many things going in his mind. So that things that is described by the poet in by using the nature's phenomena, like the sunset, the musical instrument, is describing the harmony of a person, the joy of a person. Okay. And the dark and nightness approach of death. Because the somewhere it is showing that the narrator, who is predicting that he is not having any hope, is thinking of ending his life. Thinking to end his life. Why? Because he is not having any work to do now anymore. So he is somehow, that is depicting by the night and darkness, that is depicting the death. Meaning the idea is coming in the mind of the narrator that he should end his life because he's not having any work to do now. Moreover, the land shark features have been compared with the century corpus. Since nothing is growing, the fields are bare, the frost is covering everything, the landscape look like a corpus. Okay, so the century corpus is used, the field is bare because now the industrial revolution has begun. There is a setup of the factories, machine is doing work, so that manual work is not going to be work. So he showed that the land is barren, now there is no growing field. Means the persons which are worker, which used to do the work manually by their hands, now they don't have any work. So that is depicting that there is no work. No growing field means no growth of the person. We don't have any growth now. Furthermore, we don't have any work to do now. There is no growth of the person. Okay, so that is depicting that there is land is bare and frost is everywhere. Frost means hopelessness, means there is no work, jobless, no work. Okay. The landscape look like a corpus. The poet has developed the image further by comparing the cloud canopy to a tomb and sound of the wind to a dead lament. Dead lament means the sound which is produced during the funeral. In Christian, the funeral, the sound which is produced, that is compared with the dead lament. Why he is saying so? Because he is thinking to end his life. Because he is not having any work to do now. The wintry setting is equated with the death of the century as well as with the loss of the hope. Here everywhere you will see the loss of hope and the loss in faith. Because these two are the main thing which is currently the feeling of the narrator, because he is not having to do anything. So the totally his hope, his faith from himself is totally drowned. Okay. Hope is generally associated with the spring. The speaker calls human beings, including himself, spirits, which are fearless. Thus, Hardy is romanticized nature by taking away even the capacity for renewal. Okay, means down there is telling the Hardy is telling that nature by taking, is depicting that he has romanticized that now there is no capacity for renewal. Capacity for renewal means now there is no anything that they will get a new job. Means they will get something new to do. Or if they were they have been replaced by the machines, so they can do another work. No, there is no another work for them because they only know that work which is will be done now by the machine. They only know that work, so they cannot do that work anymore. So that is no chance of renewal. Matlab, no chance of regaining something or doing another thing except what they were doing, the workers. So there is no chance of renewal or any hope that they will get another work because they know only that work and now it will be done by the machine. So there is no chance for renewal. Hardy speaker, however, finds no inspiration in the processes of the natural world. Usse koi inspiration nahi milta. He finds no inspiration. Of course, that is why he searches for meaning, because he is not knowing from where I should get inspiration or from where I will get the work and I can feed my family, I can feed myself. My life will be normal again. He has found no life in nature. Even the thrush, the hamperbug of hope, is aged and on its last song. By using the exhausted landscape as a symbolic projection of the speaker's own life, Hardy makes a bleak comment on the potential of human nature as well. Means that something, if he feels, he said that there is no inspiration in nature because he is singing the song of the thrush, but the thrush himself is aged. Means he himself is going to die. As the 19th century is going to end, the bird is also going to die and he is on his last song. So he also not find any hope in that also. He was feel happy for some time, but then again that thing has come in mind that he himself is going to die. What is going to give me hope? He himself going to die. He is aged. He is going to die right now. So what are you going to give me? You're not going to give me any hope. And that landscape, that barren landscape, totally covered with the frost, grey as grow, spectral grey. So that is showing that there is no human nature potential. Means it also commenting on the human nature potential. The poet is totally in the poem tell that how he is depressing, loss of faith. But here he also commenting on the poet. Human potential, that if you're not having anything in your life to do, it doesn't mean that you will end your life. You should move with the time. I know it is difficult to move with the time, to move with the century or to move with the scenario in the society, but you have to. This show that how low spirited you are. You cannot move with the time. If you will not move with the time, the only thing came in your mind to end your life because you're not having anything to do. So that is why here the poet is commenting on the human potential also. That you are not able to do anything. You are not having any hope. At least ending yourself, you should think about a family. No, you are not thinking. You are just thinking that you are lost in faith and hope. You are not having anything to do. So that is not right. So that is why it is also commenting, depicting the potential. That bleak comment on the potential of the human as well. Thus, the entire poem has portrayed a bleak picture of nature and the gloom emphasized far more than the joy. Means that bleak picture of nature, which is depicting the bleak, the mindset, the thinking of the human, the currently of the narrator. Okay, and which is that his mind containing more of the negativity than a positivity. Means his mind is totally negative. He's thinking to end his life. He's thinking of one step to acquire hope or acquire joy so he move further in his life. No, he's not thinking of that. So the second theme which we are going to do is the search for meaning. Hardy's own search for the meaning of the world, where he finds no hope for the humanity's future. He has given the details of the dying old world but cannot replace the dying with the new. Means the human can let to die himself, but he cannot replace that dying thing with the new. Means he cannot replace himself to the new world. Means he cannot adjust himself to a new world. He is not able to do that. He can die, but he cannot accept that. The old civilization has decayed and he find nothing to replace it. Isolated from those who have sought their household fire, the speakers see a death-haunted landscape and a glooming, growing gloom. Means the person, means he's thinking in the whole time, we also think that I am alone. How the people are in the house, burning the fire and sitting. Are they not thinking about that what we are going to do now? We don't have any work. Means himself, he is full of negativity. He don't know what to do. He's thinking in his life. And he also commenting the one person who is quietly sitting in house. Hardy himself mourned with the passing of agriculture society and saw a little cause to celebrate in England's rapid industrialization, which helped to destroy the custom and tradition of rural life. Means he also said that, yeah, there is, means you will have to replace, but there is something good also. Means you are getting a industrialization in England, the first one to establish machine. You should be happy on that, and you should, he's also happy that it's going to destroy that old traditionals and the customs, that sick minded customs of the rural life. But some are rigid to their custom, and narrator also one of that people belong to that people. That is why he's not ready to accept that change. He is not comfortable. I can understand, poet is understanding his situation, that he's not comfortable, but at least we should try. We should never lose our hope. We should always try. The speaker connection to the poet has served, and he cannot find meaning in the present. At the dawn of a new century, the thrush song, though full of hope and joy, offers little in the way of meaning. The bird is frail, gaunt, and small, and his carolings, though joyful and full-hearted, are an evening song and an about to end. Means the thrush is also giving the joy, full of hope and joy, in this little meaning. He himself very small, frail, and that caroling, that beautiful song, which is being listened in our, during the Christmas or in the church, that beautiful evening songs, though it is joyful, full-hearted, but this evening song is also going to be end. I mean, the poet says this is also going to be end. You have to move. Nothing is permanent. Nothing is permanent. You have to move. You have to move ahead. Okay. So this is our theme. Now let's move to the critical remarks of the poem. The critical remarks which is given by the poet in the poem. Okay. I know this video gonna be too long, but please, this poem is very much important and it is full of deep meaning, symbolic meaning. So I hope you will understand. Critical remarks. In the title of the poem, The Darkling Thrush, Hardy appears to have consciously used words with the along of poetic history. The word darkling means in darkness or becoming dark. Darkling, why use? Because it means that darkness, and the darkness is just currently in the human life. Mean that narrator. Okay. The speaker in the poem is able to see the landscape, but the sun is weakening. Mean the hope is caring dull, means his life, the hope of being alive or live, is somewhere is drowning. Not completely said, but is it drowning. The landscape that appears to him is barren and grey like a ghost. The day is ending and the sun is setting, making the twilight desolate. In the first two stanzas of the poem, the world appears to be physically dead. Means he himself very depressed, so he is thinking that the world is also, the narrator is also thinking that world is also dead for himself, because he is not having any hope, so the world is also physically dead. There is little to see in the spectre grey landscape. Means the grey ghost land, the barren land, full covered with deep frost. Nothing greenery you can see over there. Means low, no sound, nothing, darkness around everywhere. So that is depicting the mind of that human, mindset of the human. The eye of day is weak. Winter's rake offer little to satisfy the human need of warmth. Finally, there is no sound at all. No sound means no happiness, no joy. The image of the tangled vine stem resembling the string of broken lyres vividly conveys the utter silence of the sea. Mean the broken pieces, the broken stems of the tree because of so much cold. And that is resembling the strings of the instrument, broken string of the instrument. Broken string of the instrument which is inside us, that which produce joy and music. That string has somehow broken. That happiness and joy strings is broken, and that is why there is utter silence in the sea. Utter silence in the sea means the utter silence in the human, because he's not knowing what to do. He's completely silent, completely depressed. Don't know what to do. I'm very depressed. The landscape seems to represent the corpse of the century that is ending or dying. The very pulse of creation is dead and the nature is at a standstill. There is no hope for the next spring to come. In the last two stanzas, nature as represented the singing thrush display a sudden vigor. Means, in the last two stanzas, nature what is represented by the singing thrush means showing little hope. But that little hope is telling by whom? A age-old thrush himself is... Self is gonna die. This is last song. So that somehow it shows some hope. Okay, in the last two stanza. The song is not inspired by anything in the immediate scene or anything that the poet might understand as the reason for the song. Means he's not knowing why he's... Of course, we have also... studying the poem, that he's not knowing why he's singing so beautifully, what is the reason behind it, because himself he is thinking that there is no hope, there is no reason to sing such beautiful song, there is no happiness, not anyone going married or something is going good is going to happen for him, nothing good is going to happen, so why he's singing such a beautiful song, he's not finding any reason in that, because he himself not having reason in his life, no reason is left in his own life, that's why. Okay. The frailty of the bird itself, round and small, with the blast beautiful plumage, also prevent any song. Means his look, his appearance of the bird also indicating in the mind of the human that he himself, which is about to die, is singing such an inspirational and beautiful song. Why? What is the reason behind it? But he's not seeing that. He is at the edge of dying, but still he is having the hope and singing beautiful song, the last song. But at least he is singing. She is singing such a beautiful song. He cannot see that. If the birds in the dark, singing at night and flinging its soul into the growing gloom, it appears to be singing for obscure reason. Obscure reason why? As I told you, he is aged. No desire, no happiness, everywhere is silent, and is singing alone. Why? There's obscure reason, no reason for the narrator. Whatever prompts the bird song is not evident to the poet. Means his song is giving any evident proof or evident reason for the poet, the narrator. The illimited joy of the song and blessed hope it signifies appears too small compensation for the pain and men and women have endured through the century. Means that is a small compensation. Means if you are having lost 1,000 rupees or 10, so if someone give you 100 or 200 rupees, so it is like that only. Means they are endured so much pain for the changing of the century, meaning they are so much in pain, hopeless. So that blessed hope and the beautiful limited joy song is giving somehow compensation means somehow hope, little hope, which is not going to last long. After the bird stops singing, that will also be vanished. Okay. The thrush joy can only be heard as ironic comment on humanity's joyless state. Ironic comment, why? Because you should see me. The word is saying that you should see me. I am at the edge of death. Means I'm just going to die. This is my last song. But still, I'm enjoying it. But you are having the whole life in front of you. just because of the industrial revolution and the industry is going to replace you, you are not having any hope. You can still find some work. You should have hope to live for yourself and as well as for family. So that is the ironic comment on the human state, jealousy. The song of the bird at night, though full of joy and hope, does not bring any hope for the future, because it will not in future, and is as obscure as night. The darkling thrush is an apt title for the poem, because in the whole poem, the poet is depressing, the clueless, and at the end also, when listening the song, he will be feel good, but still also he's finding the reason why he is singing such a beautiful song, because there is no reason to sing such a beautiful song. So that is very apt title for the poem. So last but not the least, the figure of speech of the poem. Okay, so there are four figure of speech. Sorry, it's five figure of speech. Alliteration, metaphor, simile, personification, and one of the new has come, which I think. And your cynic Dicky, this is a new figure of speech. Okay, so as you can see in the starting line, the alliteration is used, like the dangle mine stems for the sky, hat sort their household fires. Okay, and metaphor, which is used to compare our nature with the human thinking, like the weakening of eye day, century corpus to the comparison of century to the dead body, cripes cloud canopy, comparison the cloud cover to a tom, and hat chosen thirst to fling his soul, comparison to the bird song to a soul, bird ki song ko to a soul of human. And the simile, the example of the simile in the poem are tangled vine stems, scourges high, like string of broken lyre. Okay, the plant stem is compared with the music instruments, broken music instrument. And your personification, a figure of speech in which human quality are given both inanimate and abstract idea, and the darkling thrush hardy does throughout the poem. Which frost, as we say examples, which frost was spectre grey by giving F a capital letter frost. Hardy has personified frost by giving it a human-like characteristic. It is a spectre grey, and that is a ghost-like, a haunted landscape. And winter dregs made desolate means winter has been personified by giving a capital W. उसको personified किया गया है, how? By giving it a capital W. Okay, personific, and the twilight as weakening eye of day, the landscape as I have also in the metaphor as the century corpse. Okay, now Sinikidi, the new figure of speech, it is a figure of the speech in which the part is made to represent the whole or vice versa. The example of Sinikidi in the poem is when the speaker referred to the people as spirit, which seemed to be favorless as the speaker. Favorless means the speaker means all other people are spirit, and they are favorless means they are clueless, hopeless, like him. So I hope like it video, please listen it. I hope it's going to get long, and do subscribe my channel, because I had explained it, that is why it get long. Okay, and thank you for being patient. Thank you.